This is a fantastic question, but it is also a question that can really complicate e-learning and online course building for you. So if you are asking this question, do I need an authoring tool? Today we are going to answer it for you, make it really simple, because that is why we even created this YouTube channel. Then we're gonna go through three easy to understand examples that illustrate exactly what an authoring tool is and why it is important to you, or maybe it's not important to you. And then we're gonna go through the difference between standalone and native authoring tools. In the end, we are going to make it as easy for you as possible to create the best content for your e-learning program or online course for your learners. My name is Johnny Havey and I'm one of the co-founders of eLearning Partners. And we created this YouTube channel to do just that, simplify your e-learning so that you can focus on your learners. That is why we are here today, is to simplify all the complicated stuff like authoring tools for you. So if you're not already subscribed, definitely hit that subscribe button right below the video. Give this video a thumbs up, turn on that notification bell, and you will get simplified e-learning content direct to you every time we release. And we release content multiple times a week. Pretty cool. So let's dive in. What is an authoring tool and do you need it? Well, an authoring tool is a tool that you use to author or create a course. So create or author a course, an online course. Let's go over some examples. How do you create a video? Well, there are different tools that you use to create a video. Obviously, what we're doing here, we're using a camera, we're filming a light board, we're creating the video. But once we capture that footage, what are we doing? We're editing it, we're adding graphics, we're compiling things together. What do you use to do that? Video editing software, such as iMovie, Adobe Premiere, and Windows Movie Maker, etc. So, an authoring tool is to courses, just as these editors and evidently I'm not great at drawing boxes, but these editors are to videos. Another example, when you are looking to create a Word document, like a report with text, or you're looking to write a book, or maybe you're writing a blog post, what do you use? Well, you use some sort of word processor, like Microsoft Word, Google Docs, or maybe Pages. That's the Apple version. So you have these word processors are to written content. An authoring tool is the same thing, but to online courses. Third example. Let's say that you have some graphics you want to create, or you want to edit some photos. Well, that would be, you know, graphics or like a photo editor. So create graphics, or we'll just put photos. Canva or Photoshop, Adobe Photoshop. Adobe gets on this board in three capacities, we'll show you. So Adobe Photoshop, these are all tools to create graphics and photos. So in the end, authoring tools are the same as everything boxed here to courses. An authoring tool allows you to build a course. So, do you need one? Not necessarily, because there are other things that also allow you to build a course. There are a lot of things. You can actually build your course out of videos. does that mean that iMovie, Adobe Premiere, and Movie Maker are authoring tools? Technically, but I'm not gonna list them over here when we actually go through authoring tools that are out there. You can have written content in your course, but does that mean that Microsoft Word, Google Docs, and Pages are authoring tools? Technically, by definition, but yet again, they're not gonna be over here when we go through the difference between standalone and native authoring tools. And then graphics and photos. They can definitely make up your course and they should be part of your course. But are Canva and Adobe Photoshop authoring tools? Technically, but no one else is gonna tell you that on the internet. So, what are two types of authoring tools? Authoring tools really are broken up into two types. The first one, as we said, are standalone, and the second one are native. What does standalone mean? Well, we honestly came up with this word because we're like, okay, what should we call an authoring tool that isn't part of another technology, that isn't part of a learning management system, that isn't part of any other type of technology? It's standalone, it stands by itself. So this, the definition would be an authoring tool, we'll call an AT, not part of another technology. It stands alone. So that's the definition. But what are some examples of standalone e-learning technologies? Well, I'm an accountant. I worked in the Big Four accounting firms when I practiced. There are the Big Four firms that we like to call in e-learning. And three of them are standalone authoring tools. There are the Big Four tools to create content in e-learning. So three of them are standalone. The first one is, hello Adobe, we're back. Adobe Captivate, you probably heard of it. Great for taking PowerPoint slides and building it into e-learning as an authoring tool. The next one, so that'd be one of the Big Four. The next one is Rise, which is a newer tool, but a highly used tool. Everyone's using it. If you're using an authoring tool, most likely you're probably using Captivate or Rise at this point. Even though the third one has been around much longer than Rise, and that is called Storyline. And both Rise and Storyline are from the same company called Articulate. Part of the Articulate authoring tool product suite. There's actually a dozen other authoring tools plus that Articulate has. So these are the big three. So who's the fourth one? Well, e-learning partners, that's us. We are the Big Four, we are part of the Big Four. I'm just kidding, we're not actually an authoring tool, but we do help companies create content. So Adobe Captivate, Rise, and Storyline are all standalone authoring tools. They do not have an LMS, they're not part of an LMS. To be fair, Articulate does sell an LMS, but these are not part of an LMS. So what does that mean? That means that just like you would create a video in iMovie, you have a finished video, but now it needs to be hosted somewhere. It needs that LMS. We have a couple of videos on our channel about why you would need an LMS. Definitely check that out. It's either linked here or here. Check it out. But really, now that you have that finished course, just like you have that finished video, now it needs to live somewhere. So that video is probably gonna go to Vimeo or YouTube, like we are at right now. The course needs to live in an LMS. So that is a standalone. There's no LMS, right? So you need to now take that course and put it in an LMS. Now, there are some new technologies that you can actually create your course so it doesn't have to live in an LMS. We have a great video about SCORM versus Tin Can, also linked above. Check that out, and you can learn a lot about what you can do with some of these authoring tools. So that's really important to know, is just like you have the written content, but where does it go next? It's done, but where is it gonna live? Where does it go? That's what standalone means. Standalone means you have it, it's done, but the course isn't living anywhere. Now native, so a native authoring tool, it's This is something you're not going to find much information on online because they're not talked about very much. A native authoring tool is an authoring tool that is a part of an LMS, a learning management system. So that means that the technology has all the capabilities of an LMS, the hosting, the collecting data, the sequencing. Like I said, check out other video on the channel. A native authoring tool allows you to build out a course within an LMS, and you don't have to use a standalone authoring tool because you can do it all in the LMS. So what is this? This is an authoring tool, so an AT, that exists as a part of an LMS. Or whatever kind of software or technology you're using to host, collect data, etc. on your course. So what are some examples of native authoring tools? Well, Kajabi, which we talk about a lot on this channel. We have a whole playlist all about Kajabi. Definitely check that out. Amazing playlist. And Kajabi is a phenomenal learning management system, business management system, and authoring tool that you can use if you are creating an externally facing e-learning program, one that you're selling to your consumers. So definitely check that out. But Kajabi has a native function that you can author your course within the Kajabi LMS. And Kajabi is actually a BMS, a business management system. It does much more than just an LMS. So that's one example. Thinkific also has native authoring abilities. Even Talent LMS and Talent Cards, which are phenomenal internal learning management systems, which means a learning management system that is focused on delivering course content, e-learning content, to employees and team members. So people that work for your organization. They have very solid internal authoring capabilities. Yet again, we have a lot of content on our channel about Talent LMS and Talent Cards and Kajabi. We don't talk about Thinkific that much, just preference. So to figure out even if you need all this, we talk about this a lot on our channel, we have a free masterclass. You can sign up. There's a link right below this video. Definitely check that out. And what that's going to allow you to do is really figure out who your learners are by figuring out their biggest challenges and then capitalizing on that by providing remarkable value to your learners with our step-by-step process that we go through with you in the masterclass. So definitely check that out. You will get immediate access and it's all for free. Now, if you like this video, definitely give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel, turn that notification bell on. So, do you need an authoring tool? Does your learner? Does any of this sound like your learner? Maybe you just need an LMS with a native authoring tool. Here's the thing, if you haven't heard of an authoring tool before, this is probably what you need, is an all-inclusive LMS and authoring tool. You're gonna save money. You're gonna save time, you're gonna get that course to market much quicker and get that learner feedback, either making some money for yourself and your company if you're selling it, or cutting down on costs if you're bringing your training to your employees so that they're more efficient and effective at their job. We'll see you in the next video.